gas remains entirely untaxed. After all, I was always taught what is good for the goose is good for the gander.
Oh, that is so true. I mean, when I think of liberals, Jock, I remember what my mamma said. Hey, even a stop clock is right twice a day.
You said it, Bobby June. We're turning the clock. Under me, I'm about jobs and I'm about families. I've had three families and I've learned from my mistakes. I think people know that about me. I've made some bad decisions. Now, I'm ready to do good.
That's just so powerful. One of the things about me is I'm not a judgmental person. I don't judge people. Well, not white people. But you've got to learn from your mistakes.
Look, nobody's made more mistakes than me, Bobby, which is why I'm uniquely qualified to run the world's sixth largest economy. Hey, I know how to jump out of a burning building, and I give back to the community. As soon as I heard about so many people losing their homes in that storm in Liberty City, I flew out there for a special screening of my latest movie. It was to bring smiles and hope during the bleakest of times. Thanks to all that showed up, by the way. And with our cut of food and beverage concessions, it was a great positive event.
Bless your heart. So are you gonna help me cook this here supper or what, Jock?
It would be my pleasure.
So let's get in here. Let me grab some pots and pans and the fats and the salt and some butter. We're gonna need a little brown sugar, some margarine, baked beans, pork rinds, marshmallows, barbecue sauce, of course. Oh, white sugar, white lightning, and the bacon. Hey, bacon's God's way of saying he loves us. Ain't that right? Listen, Jock, before we get started, now you mentioned it earlier, I'm really fired up about vaccines and immunization in this country. And I mean, these shots will give you a disease and wait for your body to just fight it out. It's horrible. Listen, we never got my stepson Randy shots, and he was just happy as a peach, living his life to the fullest right up to the end when he died naturally of polio at the age of 7. I swear he didn't regret it for a minute. He told me so on his deathbed. Mama, name a casserole after me. And I said, why, hell, of course, Randy, you sweet little angel. Bless your heart. And I did. I called it Cripple's Crock-Pot.
Available in the frozen food section of your local supermarket while supplies last.
That sounds delicious.
Oh, honey, it is. It's one of my favorite recipes. Now, then we took little Randy's body outside and, you know, all his little stuffed animals and everything that was about him and made a bonfire and roasted a pig and had a potluck supper with all our neighbors. Now, that's how you work through grief. By surrounding yourself with friends and family and plowing through it with peach schnapps and cocktail wieners, tater tot pie, and soda pudding. Oh, comfort foods are for when you need comfort. That's why they call them comfort foods. If I'm mourning a polio-ridden stepchild, I ain't gonna cry into a salad, am I? No, I'm gonna rejoice the early passing of my dearest by making a big old batch of beef enchiladas that will shut down the blood to your brain and let you live in the moment like you just had a stroke.
You are so right, Bobby. And I have to say, these here hors d'oeuvres or oopers d'oeuvres or appetizers are delightful. Mm-mm.
Thank you, honey. I like to call them whore's ovaries. Tastes great at first, but then you realize everyone else has stuck their fingers in the pudding. Also, I can't say anything in French. The only good thing that ever came out of France was the pizza.
Ain't that the truth? Take back the Statue of Happiness. It's ugly. Got a face like a sour fish.
She's just in a bad mood, isn't she? Speaking of French people, Jock, I want to talk to you about what you will do about promiscuity in this country. You know, on this show, we preach abstinence. If you don't want a bun in the oven, honey, stick it in the smoker.
I'm a big fan of sticking it in the smoker. Barbecue, tailgate parties, hell, I'd smoke anything. I teach my kids abstinence as well. My 16-year-old daughter will have her friends over to the pool, and I'll swim with them and play keep away, splashing around, you know, having fun, and I use that time to witness to them. I say, girls, this is a fantastic time in your life. You know, you're all so beautiful and burgeoning into womanhood, and a couple of you have developed fine breasts, as I see, and several about to fall out of your swimming costume. But don't do anything stupid that could ruin your life. Boys, they are trouble. Save yourself for your husband. You know, Bobby June, the important thing is that people learn about the decisions they are making in their own lives. And one decision we all gotta make is to stop letting immigrants ruin our economy. I mean, it just ain't right. You cannot get a job right now because foreigners have them. Well, America did not become the greatest country ever by letting foreigners in, and that's a fact. Listen, Bobby June. Listen, all of you. I am not a racist. I said some things, yeah, I did. That was a very long time ago. But there is a difference. If we want this country to be great again, we've got to start fighting wars we can win and stop fighting against crazy folk who ain't gonna give up. Which is why I want us to think about invading Europe again. Seriously.
How do you mean?
Now, I ain't never been one for book learning, but I'm a big fan of history documentaries. And historical television shows us that America is at its finest when we invade Europe.
You know something? You're right.
Exactly. I mean, we've spent 50 years invading Asia and the Middle East, and it ain't right. Them folks don't want us. They're too different. They eat food that's a bunch of damn paste. So what I'm gonna propose as governor of this state is that we plan a massive invasion force and go ahead and invade France. Because if there's one country we can beat in a goddamn arm wrestle, it's them limp-wristed, patronizing cheese monkeys. And I promise you this, I promise you, if Great Britain wants to stand in our way, I'll tell you what, we'll invade them too. Make them start speaking English and everything.
USA!
Now, I've seen a lot of movies, and how often is the world threatened by a creepy British guy? It's never an American, not never. So I'm saying, if we're serious about fighting terror, and I know we are, we go straight to the source and invade Great Britain. Finish off what old George started back in 1770, whenever it was.
USA! USA! USA!
That's how we're gonna win this war, Bobby June. That's how we can avenge them American lives, by killing every goddamn one of them bastards, pardon my French, because that's what love is all about.
Honey, they love you, Jock. Bless your heart. Hell, I'll vote for you. You got my vote.
Bobby June, let's talk about this election. It's really up to everybody to get out there and make a difference. You gotta do everything in your power to make sure we win. This is not a socialist country, it's not. This is America. We're nationalists, national socialists, if you will, because our society is our nation. But trust me, this is the most important moment in American history. If we get this wrong, well, we're shit out of luck. Pardon my French.
How so?
Who's that?
My producer, Ricky, speaking out of turn again. Don't worry, she's just got a tan.
Oh, okay. Had me worried for a moment there. I'll tell you what, because this is it. They are trying to steal our country away. Lawton and all his cronies, all of them cronies in the Capitol. I'm against cronyism, which is why I'm supported by only big American companies who care about things that matter and don't want business bogged down by regulations. Like pension obligations, gone. Environmental concerns, great if we can afford them, but we can't, gone. Affirmative action, what do you think? Hey, coffee over there, what do you think?
It's Ricky.
Whatever. What do you think about affirmative action? Hey, you ain't a Lebanon, is you? I mean, ain't nothing wrong with it. Some of my best friends was Lebanons, but it's unnatural and a sin. So affirmative action is gone. Having to hire foreigners is gone. Making schools accept minorities is gone. Subsidizing education is gone. Heck, education will be gone. That's why you gotta vote. It's real change. Change we want. Change back. Because I'm all about families. And families need children at home.
Jock, I have to say, I loved your reality show where you were a police officer arresting people. That little boy sure was hollering when you hit him with that nightstick. You're real serious about crime. You beat the tar out of him.
These people ask for hope. I give them handcuffs. They need a father figure. And what better figure than someone beating and sodomizing them with a nightclub?
Well, watching you chase minorities with a police helicopter is a great night of family TV is what it is. You're speaking lots of sense, Jock, but all this politics has got me hungry. I reckon we should make some dessert together. What you think?
Well, I just love that.
All righty. Let's see, what do we need? Sugar, frosting, a few egg yolks, ice cream, a bit more ice cream, peanut butter, graham crackers, red hots, non-dairy topping, sprinkles, peach schnapps, bit of bacon, my favorite, because he loves us. Full fat milk, heavy cream, cookie dough, and flour. All right, we're gonna throw them all together. Quick whisk.
I love this already. What are we making?
No, this is it, honey. It's done. After a hard day of couponing, we need simple recipes. And this one is real simple. Ain't that right, girls? I call it sweet and sticky stock car shrapnel surprise. Cause it's like a fiery accident of flavor in your mouth.
I love stock car racing. Finally, a sport that people like us can excel in and don't have some kid from the project showing off.
Try a spoonful, honey. It's delicious.
Oh, that could scare a gay man straight. It's fantastic.
I know. And it's healthy, too. Makes you smile. All right, Ricky, honey, come here. Have a taste. I know it's your favorite.
Oh, I can't, Bobby Jew. I'm watching my figure.
Excuse me. Listen, I got the so-called diabetes. Them doctors said my arteries was like cement. I've had 3 strokes, and I am fine. Because I don't worry. It's the worry that'll kill you. Come on. Come on, girl. Now, come. See? That ain't so bad, is it? Thanks for coming on the show, Jock, and we'll all vote for you in the election.
Bless your heart, Bobby June.
Bless your heart, Jock Cranley. Oh, you dog. Okay, our next guest is super exciting because she's a superstar. You've no doubt heard her songs. She's here to talk to us about adopting children from foreign countries and to sing her new song. Please welcome pop legend turned country western crooner, Samantha Muldoon. Girl, get in this kitchen right this minute.